Hey everybody, Sam here.
And Angela, and welcome to our channel.
So, ever since we announced that we bought this other homestead property, raw land in another state, and that we want to build our forever homestead out there, a lot of you have asked, and so today is the day we get to answer this really big burning question of your minds. What are you going to do with all of your buildings, all of your stuff? We have a soap shed, which you see behind us. We have my workshop. We also have an outdoor kitchen, a smokehouse, a greenhouse, a sheep barn,
and two chicken coops.
Two chicken coops, plus our raised bed gardens, and just about everything else you can think of that has made our little 1 acre property here into a homestead over the past 6.5 years. We're going to try and talk about, explain, and share our current thoughts on what exactly we are going to do with this stuff.
Are we taking it with us? So the soap shack, we bought it right at about a year ago, and we have totally outfitted it to what I need for making soap. We didn't plan on it when we bought it this way, that it is on skids, so it is movable, but we will be taking it with us. It is made to my specifications, to how I want it for just making soap. So it is coming with us. We will hire a shed moving company to come in and move this. But before we do that, we will probably empty it out of most everything so we won't damage anything in the process. So I have all of my scents and additives, and then I'm going to have crock pots and all kinds of stuff that will be boxed up and just taken separately. We'll probably leave the things like the desk, the tables behind me, the sink, of course the closet, and maybe the shelving units inside of that, but everything else will be taken out and brought over separately.
Here on the back of the soap shed, we have our outdoor load center or breaker box. We, like Angela said, we did not put this here thinking, hey, we're about to buy property and uproot ourselves, but it is going to work out very well. The fact that all we have to do is disconnect our supply lines. This feeds my workshop. This is coming from the house. But otherwise, this whole box and everything will be fine. It'll ride over across state lines and be easy enough to wire back up in the future. So, very cool how that worked out. Even though we didn't plan it, it's going to work out good.
And what about the water?
As far as the water supply, that enters in from the floor, kind of in this general area. That's an easy enough. It's a half inch PEX water line. We can disconnect it at the sink, pull it out through the floor, and then do what we need to whenever we get it over in Tennessee. No problem there either. That is a benefit of this whole system, is that, I don't know, it's kind of easy to take apart. It's not a big ordeal. Thank goodness.
I'm gonna fall on the barbed wire.
I'm behind the soap shed, not moved. Power box is right behind you. And she's over here like, is that a bug? Is that a spider? All right, this is where we're going to part ways. You've got some serious soap to make, but you guys are sticking with me. We're going to go on a show and tell field trip adventure, exploring our property. And I'm going to talk to you guys about all of our other structures and the plans. I've talked with you. I think we're on the same page. But again, disclaimer, this is our thoughts as of right now, subject to change. Let's go. Okay, we might as well travel downhill. We'll go to my workshop first. All right, what you see behind me is my workshop. It is 16 feet deep and 24 feet wide. This front roof peak is about 12 feet tall and the back is 8 feet. It is a big shop. It is a great shop, but it is one that was never ever constructed or built or designed with the thoughts of you may need to take it apart and move it later. So let's take a closer look, show you some of the problems, the hurdles, why I say that, and then we'll collectively just be sad because we can't do anything with this thing, I don't think. All right, we're inside the workshop now. You're right here at the front door, and what you see behind me, this is the left wall, the front back wall, or the right wall. I don't know, I'm pointing out directions, I guess. Thank you. workshop was built pretty traditional as far as storage shed inspired. However, it wasn't put on skids to be pulled or hauled around. It is an elevated workshop building, meaning that the foundation is post and beam. So it's up off the ground, which is cool for living on a slope, but makes it to where it really can't be moved. Also, with it being 16 feet by 24 feet and 12 feet tall, it just won't go down the interstate unless it's just not feasible. It's not a feasible thing to do from a money standpoint to hire and pay to have this moved over in one piece. So that kind of makes you think, well, hey, why don't you go and just try and take the thing apart, right? You built it. You should be able to unbuild it. Well, this thing was built and then finished out over the past 6 years. I have insulated the whole thing. Everything has been wired up. It is finished paneled on the inside, painted. There are lights and air lines run and circuits, and it's just, I don't know how I could ever take this apart and have anything left to work with that would not just be a pile of scrap or rot or just be totally wasted in the time it would take me to get it apart, haul it over, reassemble it. I don't know. I just don't think I can do that. There is a lot of stuff inside my workshop, obviously, that will be going, so it is not a great, tremendous loss. I will be recuperating everything I can out of here that is of good value, salvageable, and I can use again. In addition, I'm going to take the time to really downsize a lot of the stuff that I have. I've learned a lot over the past several years of us running our small business and getting tools and then being able to upgrade tools and kind of changing stuff. I've learned what I need, what I don't need, what I use, and what I don't use. So I'm going to take this as an opportunity to purge myself of excess stuff in my workshop. Right now, my whole workbench is full of things we got out of our storage loft over here. There are musical instruments that we've collected over the years. There are various, there's a microwave sitting there. I don't know. It's various stuff that we've got. I'm going to clean it up and try and sell it locally so we can get a little bit of cash flow, have someone who wants this items to have it, and just work out great in the end. It's a good use, and it doesn't mean we're just continuing to hoard things we don't need, and we're not throwing things away. They still have a lot of life left in them. You've got kind of an odd shot that I framed up here for you guys, because I want to illustrate something to show you that my workshop is actually a two-function space. Over here, workshop. Things of being made. Over here, this is my home office. This is kind of going to show you guys the additional hurdle we're having to face, or will have to cross, that I'm losing my workshop, but I'm also losing my home office. I work part-time from home, but it is an official job. I have to have a dedicated space that is nice and quiet, has power and computers for internet and all that stuff. So that is something that I have two in one in this building that I'm going to be losing by not taking the building over. I think in the short term, I might be cozying up in the soap shed for a home office, but that's only going to be a really, really short-term solution because I'm just going to be in Angela's way. But this is a good little split screen to show you how this one building has been double-dipped. I like the phrase, double-dip that chip. This is one of those instances. We have workshop over here for all the things we make and sell, or I guess I make and sell, and then over here is home office. If you have never seen this, there is actually a full video playlist showing where I convert this whole area, which was nothing but junk storage, into a home office. I did it on this super cheap down low, repurposing materials. My home office desk is an old closet door. The door in my home office is a busted up closet door. It's a pretty cool older video series. Shows how we were getting creative, making do with what we had, and get myself a climate controlled space for home office when this whole workshop was not even insulated. So if you're interested in that, you want to see some old blasts from the past of our channel, I'll put a link to that playlist below and you can go check it out. So coming back here into my workshop again, we do have plans for this space to be able to help us. Whenever we get to the point where we are literally moving out of our mobile home in preparation of having it moved over and set up on our new property, this workshop, hopefully at that point, will be empty of all my tools. I will have some other kind of shop solution set up, or at least dry storage for all this equipment to go into, so that we can move a lot of the stuff from the home into this building, not have to pay for any kind of a storage unit rental, and not be really stressed out on, we don't know where to put all of our things from the home that we don't need right now, but we can't get rid of and then have to buy again. So in that sense, this building is going to be very, very beneficial for that. We're going to be moving all of the appliances, furniture, larger fixtures. We're probably going to take the ceiling fans out of the house. cabinet doors. We were also suggested that anything you can do to lighten the weight on that home, you need to do it. So this building will become our staging unit, our storage unit. Once the house is over on our other property and we have it done and we're ready to move back into it, then we can rent a moving truck, load up here, go over there, and it'll be a lot easier. So for those who know us and our channel very well, you're going to know this, but I think a lot of people probably won't know this part of our story. The property that we're on right now with our homestead is family land, meaning whenever we got it, the agreement was you can build something here, but it's just what you've put on it is what you've got. The land is still family. So that's why we've not ever been able to say, and why we haven't said, hey, we're selling it all, we're cashing in the chips, and we're taking our money and reinvesting it onto our new property we want, and everything goes that way. We don't have that luxury, so what we're having to do is what we are doing, which is the best we can do. We'll take our home, we'll move it, and things that we can take, we will. That all being said, it is a big kick in the back pocket where Mr. Wallet lives for me to say that this building is got to stay here, that I can't take it. I can't do anything with it. And considering the prices of building materials and what it would cost to build a 16 by 24, 12 by 8 tall workshop building, fully insulated, electrical, there is 80 amps of electrical service in here, fully wired. It's one of those things I just can't think too much of because I can't do anything about it. So that is the story of Sam's workshop. If you also don't know, there is a separate world on YouTube of another guy very similar to me who only does videos in that workshop called Sam Craft. He does not yet know that he's about to be homeless. So if you're interested in woodworking and kind of workshop videos, you can go check it out. There's always a link to that channel below in our videos. You won't see any mention over there yet about a workshop because I don't want to open that can of worms and I know what I'm going to do with the worms whenever they fall out of that can, but it's, I guess, just more information. I don't know what I'm saying. So that is coming down the line for Sam Craft and also here, but if you go over to that channel, that's why you're not going to see any mention of it, because honestly, I don't really have a plan yet. All right, that's the workshop and the soap shed. Now let's go up to the top of our hill. Let's talk about greenhouse, barn, chicken coops, outdoor kitchen, and other homestead type stuff. Take a break for a second. So what you see behind me is our scrap wood chicken coop. We built this thing, I want to say probably 4 or 5 years ago. The most recent videos you guys saw of it was when we actually hauled it up the hill to put it here next to the barn. But before that, it was built over near my workshop on a very steep part of our driveway, grass area, that was not used. It was a really cool build. There's a full playlist to this as well if you guys are interested. Again, like a blast from the past, looking at things we've done over the years out here. But that chicken coop started off as complete scrap wood. And we had a PVC hoop house run that we built. We had a rainwater collection system for chicken watering. That was really cool, worked great. We had it all decked up, but then we moved it up here. So that's the history of the chicken coop. Our plan is to actually not take that. I think my brother Josh is going to come and check it out to see if he wants it for his new place, for his homestead, for his chickens. If so, awesome. We don't have to worry about really doing much with it. We do still have chickens. They're in a separate coop. You guys will see that soon. But for this, I'm okay repurposing or giving away and letting him get what he wants out of it, because that'll be a good use of this coop and give it some more life to let it, I can't see. Cloud. Yeah, it's like a donut cloud. There's a donut up there. I'm just patient. It'll go away and I'll have my lighting back that I need. Come on. Like, it's literally, it's a donut. It is a hole of sunshine. I'd show you guys, but then I'd mess up the camera angle and wouldn't be able to splice it. So if I can give that to my brother, let him use what he wants out of it, that's awesome. That'll mean that scrap wood became one chicken coop, became another chicken coop, and is going to become something else. So that's awesome. Now, let's go over and talk about this sheep barn, because it's kind of hidden, and we want to change up the scenery a little bit. Here is our sheep barn. Like everything else that I've talked about, I feel like a broken record, I'm sorry. We built this out of pallets. It is our pallet wood sheep barn. The posts are 4x4s. The metal roofing was reclaimed from the first little shelter we built, and otherwise, all the siding is pallets. Very cool build series. If you want to go check it out, there's links to that down below, apparently, but I guess this is what happens when a homestead is built on YouTube, on a channel. whenever it's time to take things apart and you're years ahead in the future and you want to tell people about how you built it, you can say, hey, just go look. So we currently have 2 sheep. We originally started off with 6, and we've had to downscale as we have done proper pasture management on our 1 acre. We have had to rehome the sheep that was just too much for our property. It was not a good or fun, easy thing for us to do at all. We did not enjoy doing that. It's one of those things where you're like, you partially feel like a failure or that you bit off more than you could chew. But it's one of those things we had to set our ego aside to say the best thing to do for the animals is to find them a place where they'll be happier, have the correct forage they need, and then give us a better balance of livestock for the pasture we have here. We don't do much with our sheep. We shear them once a year, and Angela has a box full of wool that she will probably someday spin. I don't know. She's as busy as I am, so I'm not turning up the pressure on her by any means. But otherwise, they're mostly pets. They do keep a lot of our lawn mowed for us. We don't have to mow a big portion of our property because of them, and that's awesome. And with us getting a lot more land where we're heading to, they're going to be even more beneficial. I don't know if we are going to expand our sheep herding flock at all. Sheep are cool, but they don't give us a bunch of benefit personally. I like to have livestock that, I mean, you can eat something from, whether chickens lay eggs, cows produce beef, sheep produce meat, but apparently that's not in the cards. We don't eat pets that are fluffy, furry sheep, so I don't know. Well, that's all things we got to figure out. So to get back on track, because I segued onto a big ramble spiel about sheep, the barn is going to stay here for now. We've got to leave our sheep here. They've got to live. They have to have their house in place, just like we do, while their next place they're going to live is being built. We have plans to do a mobile sheep barn, a mobile shelter, because mucking this stalls out after wintertime is gross. We've got some ideas for a mobile one that we can do we think will be cool, will be easy to do, and prevent us from having the barnyard effect. So we'll have to build all of that, plus add our perimeter fencing and all sorts of other stuff. So I guess the purpose that I'm getting at is the barn for now is staying because the sheep for now are staying. When the sheep have their new place done, they'll go over, and then we'll probably reclaim all the fencing, the posts, the barn material. We'll reclaim all of that as much as we can at that point.
Hey, sheep. Come here. Who wants petted?
If I were Angela up here with the camera at the gate, the sheep would be all active and animated and happy and giddy, but I'm boring, I guess. They don't really care that I'm up here. Oh well. All right, let's talk about this big white building structure you see behind me now and the fate of our greenhouse. We have got a lot of views and a lot of people probably on our channel from this thing being built, but if you're one of the few people who haven't seen it, or I won't say that, that's not nice, but hey, if you've not seen this thing being built, go check it out. Imagine that, there's a playlist down below. It was a cool project to do and one that we enjoyed, learned a ton from, and honestly, really made our homestead feel like a homestead for us. Let's go ahead and step inside, let you guys see a little bit what's going on inside, aka nothing, so don't get your hopes up. And then I'll talk a little bit more about the structure and what I've got in my head that I'm going to do with the structure. Oh my goodness. Yep, it's a storage room. Welcome to our storage greenhouse. As you can see, there is nothing going on in here that really is greenhouse related. We have the dead carcasses of plants from the garden season of past. Our strawberries are still dead in our gutter garden. Our water barrels are full, still standing. A lot of people were skeptical about that. They're full, standing, working great. But otherwise, this is a storage place. We have all of our garden gear in here. There are tillers and canning jars and stoves and pressure canners. So basically in the off season, this has become a garden storage shed for anything of that sort to get it out of the weather and out of sight. It is what it is. So Not proud about it. I wish I had a really awesome, amazing greenhouse to show you. A lush garden oasis, aquaponic tank going in the middle. I don't know, some figs and banana trees going wild. Maybe even a couple of butterflies, but I don't. This is reality. In the time that we've had this greenhouse, we have learned a lot from it. This build was wonderful in what we got, usability, but also in learning what we want more from a greenhouse and less. So with that in mind, I intend to disassemble the greenhouse. I'm going to take it apart. It will get hauled over to our new property. However, I think this is probably destined to become my interim tool storage room or shed of some sort, rather than just become a greenhouse again. We need dry storage of equipment and tools and machinery much more than we need greenhouse for starting seedlings in the growing season. So it's going to be disassembled. However, all the framing should be easy to take apart. It was all screwed together. And for the most part, I think we can haul this on a trailer. If I can find one long enough to haul the walls, I would love it. But I'm planning on hauling this over to our property. It's not going to become a greenhouse, because if I get to rebuild a greenhouse, if, I don't know, but if, I want a larger one, and I want one of a little bit different design to allow more airflow, because the region where we live, we don't really have super crazy harsh winters. We have a wonderful long growing season, and where we're moving in Tennessee, it's even a little bit warmer weather, which means even more of a growing season. When this greenhouse was built, it is on a slope, like our entire property where we live. This is nothing but a hill. So there is a pressure treated, I'll call it like a knee wall of sorts, that the frame of the greenhouse sits on top of. That was a pretty cool solution for us to get a level base to build on top of without having to do excavations and foundation work. And that's actually going to be something that benefits us as we move this structure over. All I'll need to do is, I mean, worst case scenario, rebuild like a little knee wall level and then plop this right on top of it and rebuild it back in place. The overall dimensions of this greenhouse is 12 feet wide, 16 feet long, and if I remember right, 8 feet from the ground to the peak back there. So it's about 10 feet on this side. Again, it's a slope in here. So this will be a really nice size storage shed or small workshop for me. I think it'll be a great way to reuse all the lumber and salvage all the work and material and money we put into this and take it over to give us a lot of really good benefit. So cool. It is going to mean that we're going to have to find a home for all of this gardening equipment and things we have, but gardening stuff lives a lot happier, say in a carport or like a tarp shelter. You can see like a garage. What am I thinking of? Oh, like a portable carport. Gardening stuff will be happier in that than the machines and equipment in Sam's workshop would be happy. So I think this may end up becoming my first workshop out on the new property. The next structure is the one you see right there. That is what we call an outdoor kitchen. Although honestly, it's just a covered structure that there's picnic tables, sandbox, there's some swings on it, and it is our man-made shade here on our property. We made this out of 6x6s, and it was my first attempt at a timber frame inspired structure. I think it turned out really well, considering it is over 5 years old now, still standing great, and the boys have added swings to it, and it still is holding. Pretty good job. It is a really cool structure, but I don't know how easy it's going to be to move and retain the entire design and functionality of it. That being said, it's going to stay here for the foreseeable future. However, we will take it apart and repurpose materials in the future, but we just don't have exact plans that it will become exactly what it is now when that day comes. Over here behind me, you can see our little chicken tractor that we have built. We are down to 4 chickens. We lost our pride of the flock of the property, Pantaloons. We believe she was eaten by a fox or a hawk sometime during the day. So that was a bummer. We're down to 4 little chickens now. They're laying hens and they're kind of a younger age. They are in this chicken tractor that we built a couple of months back. And we built that when we knew we were going to eventually move. We didn't know if we were getting the property we ended up getting right at that point, but we knew that was what we were going to do. We decided to go ahead and build a portable chicken coop at that time. This chicken tractor has worked out great. We move it about once every day or two. keeps them on fresh grass. They keep our lawn fertilized, and it's a really good system. It's been great as far as predator proofness and protection. They've got everything they need in one little portable shelter, and it's been a great coop for us in the couple of months we've had it. The girls are not old enough to be laying just yet, so the nesting boxes you see inside are apparently just for decoration, but we have hopes they should be laying in the next couple of months, I believe. Although with us getting into fall and winter, they may not really start laying until next spring, but that's okay. They're happy, we're happy, they're safe, and that's great. All right, I got Elijah over here because I want you to talk about your playground. This is a playground we built for you and brother, maybe a couple of, 2 years ago?
I think almost maybe 1 or 2 years ago.
So what are your thoughts of the playground? Is it something you want to take apart and try and rebuild over on our new property? Or do you think you just want to save the materials? What do you think?
Probably save the materials and build something better like a tree house at our property.
That's a pretty good idea. We don't have any trees on this property, so this was us giving our boys a tree house. On our new property, there's a couple of trees, I think.
Like 50.
Yeah, like 50. There's a couple of trees you guys have already picked out for great treehouse trees. So this is probably going to be another one of those projects that we take apart, but just save the material for repurposing on something else later. Probably a treehouse, because why not? It works good, right?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'll make this quick. You're extremely busy, but I'm done with the video.
Cool.
I talked about all of our structures. It feels like we have 1,001 structures, and how basically we're moving the soap shed, the workshop we're going to cry over a whole lot, and the rest of the stuff we're pretty much going to disassemble, repurpose.
As much as we can, yes.
Yep, as much as we can.
We like to build. We can't help it.
Yeah, we do. We like to build.
We want something, we build it.
Yeah.
So.
All right. Well, hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. Remember, there's apparently like 1,000 links down below to all the videos of us building all this stuff. So check it out if you're interested. Hopefully you got a lot of your questions answered. If not, leave us a comment down below. Otherwise, I'm going to let you get back to making soap because I've, like, you got to go.
So. I do.
Here.
See you guys next time.
Bye.